To give chest compressions to your pet during CPR, you first want to make sure that you're both positioned appropriately. Your pet should be on his side. Either side is fine, and you should be positioned above him so that when you're giving compressions, you can lock your elbows. You don't want him too close to you because if you have to do compressions this way, you'll lose a lot of strength. Now, your hand position will be a little bit different depending on whether or not you have a big or a small animal. For dogs that are about 25 pounds or bigger, you want to put your hands over the widest part of the chest. So generally back a little bit closer to the spine in the middle of the chest, right about here for Quinn. You're going to put one hand on top of the other. Again, lock your elbows, and that's how you're going to give the compressions. For cats and smaller dogs, you want to put your hands over the heart, and to find where the heart would be, bend the top leg until you find the point of the elbow. Where the point of the elbow meets the chest is about where the heart is going to be, and that's where you want to position your hands. Again, one over the other, or in very small animals, you can put your thumb and fingers on either side of the chest and squeeze that way. All right, Quinn. Now, for demonstration purposes, I'm going to lay this towel down so that you can see my stuffed animal a little bit more easily. But the basic rules are going to be the same. Put your hands in position over the heart or the widest part of the chest, depending on the size, over the animal with elbows locked, and compress the chest. Each compression should be even and should compress the chest by about a half to a third of the width of the chest, making sure that you release completely in between compressions. Now, you're going to want to give about 100 to 120 compressions per minute, which is a lot, and it's also very difficult to get that pace down. So some tricks that you can use is give the compressions to the beat of one of a couple songs. One would be Stayin' Alive by the Bee Gees, or if you prefer Queen, you can go with Another One Bites the Dust. So again, position your hands, lock your elbows, and give compressions as so. Now, if you're by yourself, you're going to need to interrupt compressions after about 30 to give a rescue breath. You're also going to want to check the pulse at that time to see if it's returned. If not, immediately return to chest compressions. Ideally, though, you're going to have a partner. And so if you have more than one rescuer, you should be alternating roles. While one person is giving chest compressions without interruption, the other person is giving rescue breaths, one about every 6 to 8 seconds. Now, giving chest compressions can be exhausting, so you will need to switch roles about every 2 minutes. And these transitions need to be smooth so that we minimize interruptions in chest compressions. Don't forget to check for a pulse, and if you do find that the pulse has returned, you'll need to transport your pet immediately to a veterinary facility. Chester. Chester, he's not breathing. I can't feel a pulse. Anna, I'm gonna need your help. Can you give him a breath every 8 seconds? Okay, it's been almost 2 minutes. Can you come around and tell me if you feel a pulse?
No pulse.
Okay, I'm starting to get tired, so I'm gonna need you to switch out with me. Can you put your hands over mine? And on the count of three. 1, 2, 3, go. And we're gonna continue like that until we either get a pulse back or 10 to 20 minutes have gone by.